Atmosphere is more like
some sense, I like to think about it as we're living in an ocean of air. And I mean, it makes sense because we also fly these heavy things called airplanes in this ocean, and they wouldn't be able to fly if it weren't for all that, mass.
Stars in the night sky are not actually stars.
Solar system has 8 planets, and we are not counting Pluto anymore. I mean, out there in the outer solar system, there are a lot of Pluto-like objects, and some of them are even larger than Pluto. So you can't really count Pluto as a planet, can you? Otherwise,
it's 140%.
squeezes out freely, pierce every four centuries. So I think we're all familiar with the concept of a leap year, and that's where it's coming from. X-rays cannot reach the Earth's atmosphere, so astronomers can only detect them using space telescopes. Well, and that's actually a good fact for life here on Earth, because high energy radiation like X-rays can be pretty damaging to all of life. So good thing it cannot reach us down here. The sun has sunspots, the dark spots on the sun's photosphere. That's the surface. They are 2,000 degrees cooler than the rest of the surface. And that's actually a significant difference. That's about 1/3 of the average surface temperature of the sun. After the Big Bang, there was antimatter, the mirror image of matter. Antimatter and matter destroyed each other when they met. Matter just won, but the universe was left almost empty. And as of now, we have no idea why matter won. There could have been, or even there should have been, the same amount of matter and antimatter, and they could have annihilated each other completely. So either there was more matter than antimatter to begin with, or somewhere out there is all the missing antimatter. The afterglow of the Big Bang can still be detected as microwave background radiation coming from all over space. Dishes in the space telescopes have to be made accurate on 2 billionths of a millimeter. And sometimes facts like these are just mind-blowing to me because of, the achievements we as humanity have made, the things we are able to manufacture. It's just amazing. That's just a huge team effort, isn't it? You can see another galaxy with the naked eye, the Andromeda galaxy. Remember, that's the other one from our local group. But you should probably avoid highly light polluted areas like cities, because there you can't really see it. Dried up riverbeds show that Mars probably once had water in its surface. There is sometimes ice at the poles and maybe water on the ground. The history of Mars could have been very interesting. It may have had water and a thicker atmosphere, and now it's all gone. The few